Today's video is sponsored by Bill and Melinda Gates. Today we're doing an experiment to see if we can make paper that's impervious to fire. Guys, we're currently in the studio, which is completely covered with thin strips of paper, and we've got blow torches. Seems like a terrible idea, right?
So this might seem incredibly dangerous, but the paper that we're surrounded by is actually crepe paper, and it's actually treated to be fire resistant. So while it'll burn, it's not gonna catch fire.
You mean if we start swinging these blow torches around, it's not gonna burn down the whole studio?
Why don't we find out? Some of you may be surprised to know that paper can be fireproof. And as excited as we are to share the surprise with you, we've also partnered with Bill and Melinda Gates to share with you 9 of their biggest surprises from 2018. You can read about these surprises in their annual letter, which we'll talk about in a bit. But first, let's learn some more about this paper.
So we can see that we've got plenty of spots where it got singed, it got burned. But even when you've got the blowtorch concentrated on it, it doesn't go anywhere. The fire doesn't spread.
This would be a horrible fire starter.
Would not work at all. 0 out of 10. As you can see, our studio is remarkably not burned down, despite being lined with paper and being hit with fire. So this fire resistance to paper is what we're trying to do today. We're gonna take a look at a few different recipes of doing this at home and see which one works the best. Here's the basic idea. We've got 3 different recipes we're gonna test to try and make paper more fire resistant. We'll see how they hold up against a stove, a lighter, and a blowtorch. All right, we've now seen the commercially available fire resistant paper. Let's clean up a little bit and see if we can make our own. We do have another type of pre-made heat-resistant paper, and that's called parchment paper, which is usually for baking.
So parchment paper is treated with silicone, and that makes it so that it's slightly more moisture-resistant, but also fairly heat-resistant. However, heat-resistant does not mean that it is burn-resistant.
Parchment paper is designed to go in ovens, and while it's great for things not sticking to it and it not burning up in an oven, that doesn't mean it's actually fireproof, as Callie was just showing you. It clearly can be lit on fire, and it actually says on the box to not touch it to an open flame. We've got 3 different recipes that we want to try to make this fire-resistant paper. The first is one I found online talking about how you can use water with some borax and some boric acid dissolved into it and soak the paper in that.
For our second recipe, we are going to be doing basically the same thing, except we are substituting our water for methanol. Methanol is going to evaporate much faster than water, so our dry time is going to be a lot quicker. It also won't make our paper wrinkle.
As a third recipe, we're using one that's something Grant has shown you before quite a while ago. He showed you how to make your own rocket wadding. This is paper that goes in between the end of the burning fuel and the parachute before it gets launched out. You don't want your parachute to melt or light on fire, so you use a heat-resistant wadding in between the two so it will still pop the parachute out, but not add too much heat to it. And what he used for that was just water and baking soda. Soak the paper in that, pull it out, let it dry, and that created a fire-resistant paper as well. So we're gonna try all 3 of these, and we're gonna see the advantages and disadvantages of each one.
So for our first recipe, we have a bowl of hot water. We've got 4 cups of hot water, and we're going to add a 1/4 cup of borax and a 1/4 cup of boric acid. Stir it all up and let it dissolve.
While she's stirring that one up, I'm going to get our methanol version of the same thing going. We're not gonna have as much of this. We're just gonna use 1 of these little containers. Now we're gonna do about 2 tablespoons each of the borax and the boric acid. All right, here we go. We've got methanol with borax and boric acid in it. So what's fun about this is you may have seen us before using methanol and boric acid for a pretty fun effect. Green fire! Now, Callie has poured her solution into this pan already, and it doesn't mix into the methanol quite as well as it does into the water. So we're just gonna let this sit and see if any of the powder settles out to the bottom, and then we'll try and pour it off the top into the pan. While we're waiting for that, we're gonna start mixing up our baking soda as well. The good thing about the baking soda is that you just keep mixing it in, and once it doesn't dissolve anymore, any that didn't dissolve will just settle out to the bottom, and then you can pour it off. We've now got our three pieces of paper and they all say what we're gonna be soaking them in. So we've got the water and sodium bicarbonate, also known as baking soda. We've got the methanol, borax, and boric acid. And then we have the water, borax, and boric acid. We're gonna take one of these pieces of papers and thoroughly soak them, like really let them absorb the liquid all the way through the fibers of the paper. Then we're gonna take them out and let them dry. Now, trying to make fireproof paper using methanol may seem a little counterintuitive because, as we showed, methanol is flammable, and with boric acid in it, it burns green.
While these dry, let's talk about Bill and Melinda Gates' annual letter. Guys, some of you may be surprised to know that paper can be fireproof, but what you may be even more surprised to know is that textbooks are actually becoming obsolete in the US. Students who are using digital tools have actually been found to be getting better grades, and this is just one of the 9 surprises the Gates found in 2018.
We both had our own share of surprises in 2018. Callie, what would you say was your number one 2018 surprise?
I joined a YouTube channel.
Were you not planning on that ahead of time? Is that not a New Year's resolution for 2018?
You know, I think the application went out sometime in about March. At the time, I was a sculptor. I was an illustration student. This came out of left field, and I was honored and just so excited to be a part of this channel. It was amazing. The guys have been fantastic to work with, but no, this blew me away. This has been a dream come true, but this was probably one of the biggest surprises of my life.
Very cool. For me, surprises in 2018, especially about the channel, I have to say I was super surprised at what videos did really well and what videos seemed to underperform. Some of the highest performing videos were things like putting food in a vacuum chamber and seeing what happens if you try and melt magnets down, and they really took off a lot more than I was expecting them to. And some of the ones that I kind of personally thought were really cool, I was like, oh, this is gonna be so great. They just kind of didn't go anywhere. So it's fun to see what other people are the most interested in and see what the results are from that. While we experienced our own surprises in 2018, the Gates shared 9 of theirs in their annual letter. Head over to gatesletter.com to read the surprises they've encountered in their work and how those moments are prodding them to help make the world a better place. I think they're all dry.
I think so.
Tastes kind of like baking soda.
Do you regret that?
A little bit.
I regret it for you.
Thanks. Now we want to do some tests. We want to apply heat to these. I'm thinking a stovetop.
Sounds good.
A lighter.
Yep.
And a blowtorch.
That's my favorite.
All right. To start off, we've got a control piece of paper. It's just paper. There's nothing even printed on it, and it's not treated with anything fireproof. We've got a pretty hot stove going here. We're going to see what it does. Water and baking soda. Here goes. Set it on one corner. Whoa!
Oh.
That very, very quickly turned dark.
That went so much faster than the regular paper.
It did. I'm just curious.
Was it a heat difference?
Yeah,
did the stove
could the
just heat
stove
up?
Have already been hotter? Is that what did it? Well, it was different.
Oh, and it's on fire.
Okay, so the stove wasn't properly heated that first test. For our second test, it was, and this lit on fire very quickly. So initially, I thought, oh, it's doing terrible. It just burned so fast. But then compared to our properly heated stove test, that actually did great.
It
didn't light on fire. Water, borax, boric acid. Here goes.
Already better.
Charring, shrinking weirdly.
That's amazing.
Really not lighting on fire though.
Not
so
at all.
Even this part that's like the ember, that's going way slower than the other stuff. And we do not have any flames right here. Finally, the methanol, borax, and boric acid. Turning black.
Wow.
Shriveling.
And
it's on
fire.
And it's green. Let's move on to lighters.
Yes. Water, borax, boric acid.
1, 2, 6, 7, 8. 10, 11, 12.
I
don't think it's gonna catch on fire.
It's not catching on fire.
So it's burning, obviously, and it actually seemed to burn almost the same speed, maybe a little bit slower, maybe took like an extra second before it turned black, but it didn't catch on fire. Methanol, borax, and boric acid. Now this one we got to light on fire with the stove.
We did, and
there's
it was green.
A little bit of green flame in there. 1, 2, 6, 7, 8, 10, oop. I thought I saw some flame coming off it, but it...
little
tiny, tiny bits of flame.
Little bit, just barely catches.
But as soon as the heat source goes out, away, yep.
Baking soda. That turns black much faster.
Oh, it was on fire for a second.
It was on fire for a second, but then it went out.
So far, I would say that two for two, our water, borax, and boric acid is doing the best. Well, should we try our torches?
Yeah, we should. All right, blowtorch.
Regular paper.
Ready to paper. This is gonna take a long time. One, two. That was about 1 second. Water, borax, and boric acid. One, two, well.
But it didn't stay.
About the same amount of time to start burning, but it's not burning anymore.
That's weird. Yeah.
Goes right out.
Methanol, boric acid, and borax.
That one sustains
still on
a flame.
Fire.
Yeah.
Still on fire. It's spreading a little. Oh, and now it's out. Baking soda and water. Here goes. One, two. Still on fire. Still on fire. It's now out. I think the accelerant is gone. I don't think there's any methanol traces left that's making it burn better, but I think the water is doing a better job of dissolving the two chemicals and really getting them to spread and really get into all of the fibers of the paper. That's my guess.
I like it. So our water, borax, and boric acid is definitely more flame resistant than any of the others. So, can you make fire resistant paper?
Yes, you can make fire resistant paper, and it's not that difficult.
Nope, most of these supplies you can find. The easiest one obviously will be baking soda and water.
If you really want the best fire resistance, then the water, borax, and boric acid is your best combination. That stuff really does not like to spread a flame. It acted quite a bit like the crepe paper.
It really did.
As long as there is direct heat on it, it was burning, but as soon as you take that off, it just kind of goes out. Thanks again to Bill and Melinda Gates for sponsoring this video and sharing their annual letter with us. Guys, go to gatesletter.com and learn about more of the things that they found surprising about 2018. Guys, that's not all. We've always got more for you to see. That box up at the top is going to take you to our last video. You should go check that out. The other box is going to show you what YouTube thinks you should be watching next. And if you hit this bomb here in the middle, you'll be subscribed to our channel so you don't miss out on a video. Don't forget to ring that bell, and we will see you in the next one. Talk to you then.